Hi, my name is Markku Markkula. I work for the Aalto University as the advisor for our presidents and on that focusing on the European Union strategic issues. So much of my presentation is linked to, on a broader scale, to what is going on globally, but especially focus on some of the recent European Union developments and using then practical case studies, some examples, evidences from the Aalto University, but from the other universities, not just in Finland, but from around Europe mainly. To start with, I wanted to immediately conclude some of my key messages. So how to develop these attractive innovation ecosystems and environments for knowledge co-creation. So I stress heavily co-creation, so it's not just individual researchers or business people doing something, but working together with some of the others. So from that perspective, some of the key developments nowadays are linked to the ecosystem thinking. Not anymore just the traditional value chains or even not just value networking, but what does it mean both locally and regionally and how that is linked then to knowledge resources globally. The key element on this is very much so that we engage users, the customers, so that the whole process is quite strongly customer targeted and quite often customer driven as well. We want to catalyze more open innovation as a systemic approach to development and speeding the development to meet the needs of society and certain businesses definitely as well. So one of the key developments is to focus on entrepreneurship or actually the entrepreneurial discovery as a general process. And then going further for this through experimenting, piloting, demonstrating some of the outcomes. If we then go on, so briefly, kind of content of my presentation, that's summed up. So first, a bit about the background, why this presentation for you as an audience, and then a strong message on that. So how to integrate real life and virtual reality, so to get more out of the latest ICT development. Some links to EU innovation policy, then giving a kind of big picture about the innovation ecosystems, and again some of the experiences operating through clusters and nowadays through regional innovation ecosystems, how to conceptualize those for the use in different regions around the world. Then a few specific activities and concepts again about the knowledge triangle, which means the synergy between research, education and innovation. Then a few words about living labs and finally summary, how to move on. And kind of strong starting point is so that this is already a new digital planet that we are living on. And that means as well so that the businesses with respect to this are growing enormously. We have here in Finland a lot of research on that and a lot of outcomes, and we are very convinced that this is one of the key instruments for making the change to happen. So use more digitalizing as an instrument for renewing different developments and businesses. I want to take one picture, one evidence as a recent background which has influenced us as well strongly. That was the article in Harvard Business Review already some years ago, but highlighting the results using the indicators as indicators, the research and development, and especially the focus on innovation. And the author of that, John Kao from the US, so he pointed out the role of Finland is very special because we are strongly now moving to a new kind of entrepreneurial mindset. And that's what we have a lot of evidence that it works, and especially the young digital generation is making the change to happen. And taking that as a guiding principle for my presentation as well, so what I did learn from John Kao was that, as he stated, the journey to innovation is a three-act drama. And we link that to the Aalto development in the transformation team, focusing on one hand to the entrepreneurial mindset, focusing the pioneering regions and cities, and then linking everyone more towards real life, real case kind of approach. So having students as the key instrument for this mentality change. And on that, so as I pointed out, so that we need to have a good understanding on the region, not just ours, but the benchmarking and bench learning, so learning from other regions who have the same interest. And then we move on, deeper understanding of innovation and what and how to work for that and through that. And there I'll have some practical concepts in my presentation for that. Starting with so that we need to have a strong link to the whole real-life reality. And this is where we have worked on within our kind of campus development. Aalto head campus, main campus, is located in the western part of the Helsinki metropolitan, so just 10 kilometers from downtown Helsinki, the city of Espoo. And there this picture shows on the situation a few years, maybe 10 years from now, when the metro has been extended, the Ring 1 is reorganized. So a lot of investments in infrastructure and housing, both for people living, but as well for business development premises for new businesses. And the strong move on that shows on that the city, together with the private investors, are doing these investments for from 4 to 5 billion euros value during the next 10 years, or practically less than 10 years. But the driver of the change, so it is Aalto University, together with the existing businesses and new businesses that are starting there. And I added there a few of the companies. We have for long worked with Nokia and other big companies, and now the new entrepreneurial companies like Rovio, so they are moving on, they are having a strong influence on that. And then what I took there, the let's be lovebirds, that has been the message coming from Aalto, from our Aalto design factory through the students as well. So working on with this is a real challenge for us. What is important as well, so that we don't anymore work traditionally only face to face, but we use visualizing instruments, we use three-dimensional pictures, visualizing equipments, but as well we go much deeper than we take four dimensions, five dimensions, whatever they are. And this is something that we call here as a regional information modeling. So all these pictures, they are from the real life, both present kind of state of the art situation, but as well using on that and moving to the next phase when we add their new buildings, new innovative working environments. But we add there as well, as you can see, there are some islands where we have our showcases, our practical work can be linked, and everyone from around the world who is working with us can be integrated to this. So please go to have a look at this. There is the website as well, to meshmoon.com, which is actually a product, open source product, based and developed further by one small Finnish company, but now already in active use with many both researchers, but as well like we have used that for schools as well, or schools around in Finland in many cases are using that. And integrating as well, so here we show that how we have built these islands as a research learning process basis. There is said that Aalto Nonaka workshop, so Japanese professor, kind of guru of knowledge management, Iguchiro Nonaka, has visited us as well several times. So we have integrated part of that material or worked in this virtual environment with him and several of the others. And here briefly explain as well about one extensive research program, energizing urban ecosystems, which is an extensive 20 million euro project funded half by the industry and half by the Finnish research authorities. So national funding altogether, but strongly industry driven. Link then this to the EU development, European Union. So we are in European Union. We are starting the new program period, 7-year program period with 7 flagships, where the research, the new research framework is called Horizon 2020. And the new thing for that is that we are linked to the that to the integrating recent research, scientific excellence to societal challenges and industrial change as well. And here the targets having a strong societal impact as well. This is my own kind of brief summary of this change, where we are focusing. And this is important that the focus is on more and more towards societal innovation. So with certain structural changes, mental changes, etc., not just having a third sector involvement. So it can be done wherever around the world as well, and being integrated to some through the digital global networking with us as well. And we look this very strongly so that we get concrete results out of that. What is new on that? So we integrate these digitalized real-life developments using our own, not just the university campus, but the surrounding businesses, residence area as well, to be the kind of a test bed for societal innovations, and moving through that strongly to open innovation, but having that as a collaborative effort globally. So a lot of the best talents on that, on open innovation developments, they are linked to our development as well. And there with the yellow color you see smart specialization. That is one of the EU recent developments. Why this is important, what is happening now in innovation in general on moving to innovation ecosystem thinking. This is briefly stated from Professor Prahalad, so how he gave a very clear message so that value will increasingly be co-created with customers. The second point, that no single firm has the knowledge, skills and resources it needs to co-create value with customers. So it means a strong need for a new kind of collaborative mindset and businesses as well, based on that, using the value networks with the subcontractors, with knowledge creators. And the third point, emerging markets can be a source of innovation as well, where universities are or other educational establishments, so they are very often the drivers of this new experience-centric development of value creation. I wanted to add here something which was a strong message for me, a learning process, when I was visiting University of Cambridge in UK and having there a chance to talk with Professor Sir Mike Gregory, how he showed the whole system in a way that industry, marketplace and society development, it's not just only based on technology integration or technology base and development on that, but strongly on the strong fundamental research as well. So this is strongly research based, and that is the message for the universities globally, that we need this as well. And integrating then these different layers and levers for making the change to happen. And from that, so then I looked through so some of the recent studies on ICT and how that and the innovation is seen. And traditionally there has been so that this business model levers the development of value proposition, value chain, target customers has been linked to technology levers, so product and service, process technology and enabling technology. But what was missing on that newly published book, so was they did not mention there heavily enough the cultural levers. So I added there this regional innovation ecosystem space, meaning the barn flow from the professor Ikujiro Nonaka, design, mindset and learning as well. So on integrating them, so having this quite broad scale what we have. Now I want to integrate this to the regional model. So my message strongly is that we need to modernize the triple helix concept. So then that means more, so we are adding there the societal perspective, but other dimensions as well, meaning that this is the regional innovation ecosystem. Traditionally, companies, public sector, administration, academia work very strongly together, but now we add these new dimensions. And this we have been experimenting in Finland, so this slide tells about the clustering policy that we have had actually from the mid-90s already. In most of our cities we have had part of the centers of expertise focusing on and funding the basic funding coming from the government for having this collaborative platform operating. Then all the projects and others have been then funded through the project work. And as an example, so it means that it's not only one location with one specific cluster, but it's networking with the same cluster policy, but as well through the borders between different clusters. So this breaking the barriers, breaking the borders is a crucial instrument. What we have learned from that, so as well, so that now we stronger move to mindset issues, and that's where we have these new kind of developments, having the students, the young digital generation to play a crucial role. And I have included here a few examples, kind of evidence. This is one 2011, what happened with the Aalto startup community, totally student driven activities and the Aalto Center for Entrepreneurship. So how new businesses have been, and on the list you see the names of several newly established companies, investments on those or on the venture capital or the growth of their businesses. So this really has been an evidence that even a big changes can be made to happen. Linking that to the regional system development, so if you want to move on further on this conceptualizing, this is the three-stage operations, creating certain preconditions, initiating transformation towards regional innovation ecosystem, and then orchestrating the new businesses, not just managing the processes. And here they are a bit more detailed. And I have here as well, so I want to show the book, the knowledge triangle. So, and this is where we have described these, not just the Aalto University cases, but some of the others as well. And this book is a good source of basic information on going deeper and trying and then to apply the developments to your own. This is the concept of knowledge triangle, simplified format, so having more synergy between research, education and innovation. And this the same thing a bit more detailed, and that's showing on that if the, and when we want the university to create these preconditions for innovation, so we need to have this a deeper understanding of the innovation itself. And this is how we have structured the processes. We need more of these platforms. And when we look that from the innovation and education side, so then it's a platform for working life development. If we look integrate research and innovation more, so it's a platform for foresight and co-creation, or if it's only linking research and education more on that, so platform for blended learning. And briefly, again, so tackling the grand societal challenges, this is the process description. And on that, so we have seen that we need to have more global partnerships and create these service platforms. And for that, we several years ago already developed the Aalto Campus, Aalto Camp for Societal Innovation, and showing here just a few pictures out of that. So working with people from around the world, students, researchers, professors, real business people as well involved. So that's a real learning experience. Now I want to sum up so that we need these new concepts, This is the concept of Living Lab development in the Helsinki region. This is the concept of Living Lab development in the Aalto University itself. I don't go to detail, you can study these slides a bit further. And this is the concept for regional entrepreneurship excellence development. We need these different instruments and different phases. And finally, summing, we link this on a broader scale to EU development, European Union, pioneering regions, full use of ICT, regional innovation ecosystems, user-driven open innovation, and speeding up the development, scaling it up. And that is actually my strong message, so that integrating real-life practice to virtual reality, and that makes a lot of sense. Then we are partnering globally as well. Thank you.